Hello and welcome back to Let's Play Hearthstone Arena. Currently 4-1 up with our mage deck. As I mentioned previously, we do not have any mage specific cards like the common ones, Flame Strike, Frost Bolts, and Fireballs. We don't have any of those. What we do have is a Blizzard, two Faceless Manipulators, which did save me some games, I guess, and just an all round decent deck with decent cards. Not a lot of card advantage. Excuse me. Just stretching a bit. For some odd reason, my back is being a nuisance. I don't think I want to keep this except the Youthful Brewmaster, like it's a 2-drop. But the others, yeah, can easily be replaced by something else. Not actually what I wanted, not a big fan of Counterspell. Well, against the Paladin, maybe a bit more. Because they rely on spells pretty heavily. Most of their big 4-drops are either weapons or Blessing of Kings or Consecration. And Counterspell is actually decent against that. And we do draw the Fledgling Ghoul again, so we'll end our turn here. So he'll have initiative and he'll have... well, we even have something better, but that doesn't matter because I can always shoot it down. Sure, it cost me my turn, but that's fine. And then depending on what it does, I can start doing things. Like, I can now this turn play Counterspell, hope he plays a weapon, use the use for that later on, try to play the control role, I don't know yet. As I said, it depends on what it does, if it just makes a token, I'm obviously just playing the Youthful Brewmaster here. If he coins out the Sword of Justice, I'm gonna get it. Which is just gonna be really, really good. He's thinking though, it's just a coin. So I guess I'll run out of Flesh Eating Ghoul. Just so it can grow a bit faster. Yeah, that's fine. Like if he has a coin into something, like a weapon. Oh, door's open. I had to close the door there for a second. For some reason, this door just doesn't seem to close well. And he does have a Blessing of Kings here. Yeah, as I said, most of the time they have big 4-drops. And that's one of them. So, the best way to deal with this, I guess, is... just running out of creature to trade. I'm not sure about that. We'll just ping it just in case he has removed for this. I was thinking about playing a second creature, but I think with the faces that would just run into consecration. Yeah, maybe I should have pinged it on his turn. True Silver Champion, not a big issue because of Acidic Swamp Ooze. And this is the reason why I start pinging this shit. So we're just Ooze and Counterspell. Or that. So yeah, now we have initiative, it does have a 2-card advantage. Damn weapon is really good. Yeah, Blessing of Kings, really strong card. 2-7, huh? Let's think about how to handle that. We can Faceless Manipulator it, get our own 2-7, but I think that's a bit too early. I think we're just gonna run it like this. If he attacks this, I can then Faceless Manipulator it and kill it. He can't play Consecration because of the Counterspell. He already used his coin, so he can't freely trigger it. Question is, do I want the 5-4? I don't think I do. Unless he has something really good here. I want to copy it, but at this point, nothing good is there. He has Divine Argus, or the Defendant, that gives taunt. Like that's the only thing that makes sense here that he's thinking about. He could have something else that pumps, or that. Yeah, okay. You can basically kill everything, and then what? And have this in play. Or we can make a 5-4. We're 4-5 around. Let's make a 4-5. Kill that. And ping that shit. So now he can't trade there. Obviously I could play the Arcane Golem, but not willing to. Yet. This could be a spell. This could not be a spell. It's the second Yeti. Yetis are so good. What does he have here? I don't know. That's a good one. That'll do, I guess. Well, maybe I want more value out of it. Can I, though? Can I force him to give me more value out of my Blizzard? I ping this now. Play something stupid. Hope he overextends. Seems unlogical that he would overextend there. You can't, I'm gonna get more value out of it, but just in a totally different way. Because this way at least I'll only take 3. It's an easy one to deal with. As is that. I don't mind taking 3 every turn. That on the other hand is a pretty annoying card to deal with. And I guess I have to pop Blizzard now to slow this down a bit. So he still has a card advantage over me, of course. A 2-card advantage even. And he has a bunch of big creatures and gives it even taunts. So that's actually really tough for me to beat now. Yeah, I guess. But then I can't. This is tough because I actually want to kill this with this combination. But then I can't copy it. Still think I have to though. We'll take 10 here. He can trade this 3-1 and this 1-1 token for it, which is what I would do. Oh my god, I am taking 14 here. Well, that's way better for him now, huh? Yeah, this game is over. I don't see myself winning this here. I can't get rid of this, I have no more wipes. I've gone cold, but yeah, well played. I'm gonna go see this one. So I was on the back foot, never managed to get up. Which lost me the game and actually gets me the second loss. Not a bad player though, or not a bad deck. I think he played his cards pretty well. Played around Flamestrike there. Forced it out with a 4-6. And maybe I should have waited a bit longer. But I don't see how with my hand I could have handled the 4-6 in an easier way. Could have played the spell damage, gave it +2 attack, but then it would die to... maybe that would have been the play. Nah, it would have attacked the 4-4. Wouldn't that be fine? So I want to keep these two, get rid of the golem. Dark Iron Dwarf, not that bad. 2-drop, 3-drop, 4-drop. We're up against the Warlock though. He mulligan 3 guards, so I assume his 1 guard is gonna be a flame imp or some sort. It has to be blood imp or flame imp, like why wouldn't he mulligan it then? Or it's a really good 2-drop. It's a 3rd card, yeah, that one that it just highlighted, that it didn't mulligan. So we'll find out what it is pretty soon, I guess. When it finally decides on casting something. Actually, it doesn't cast anything. Which I found to be odd, but okay. So we can't remove this with anything either. And actually I played a bit of Constructed just a second ago, and for some reason I played against a Warlock who played two Hellfires. Like Hellfire compares, if you compare Hellfire with all the other cards that wipe, it does damage to your own creatures. Like Hull Nova heals your creatures, Consecration just does the opponent's creatures, and stuff like that. It seems illogical to do so. I guess this is the reason why I didn't play that. But I'm still gonna attack him, because I don't think that he's gonna have a remove for my 3-2 here, and he's probably gonna to attack it himself. There's not a lot that's gonna give it 2 health, is it? So yeah, he's gonna heal himself up, that's fine. A good generating card advantage here. Just by this, we're actually even on cards at this point. Which isn't that common. I can't actually make a 2 and 3 drop next turn because this will bounce something. Well, I can do it if I do it in a certain order and this is dead, but I actually want to run this out and then run these into each other. So he finally decides on life tapping for the very first time. See what he's gonna do, huh? Does he have Demon Fire? No. He probably has a 3-3 taunt and 3-5 taunt. Ah, and he kills that, of course. Yeah, this is fine. It's probably the easiest way to get rid of that creature. He actually, this card, like, it's fine in Constructed where you can build a deck around it, but it's not that great in Limited because it's pretty hard to deal with the loss of a mana crystal. Like, if he has Mortal Coil, even if he has Mortal Coil, I can still kill this and be left with a 4-1. Even with anything that removes, basically, this card is gonna be golden. And that's actually a mistake, what he just did. Because little old Draggy is gonna kill him in the face. They could have said, well, maybe I should have done that. Plus this attack, to attack him, pinged it, and then I had a 4-1 and a 2-1. Compared to 2-4 and 4-4. Maybe that was better. Should have thought about it a bit longer, I guess. But where he's operating 5 mana, I have my initial turn on 7 mana, so I'm actually have a 2 mana lead here. And as a Warlock, once you get behind, it's gonna be really hard to come back from. As I said, Hellfire, not a great wiper compared to the other one. Consecration, only opponents. Blizzard, Flamestrike, only opponents. Holy Nova, only opponents. Hellfire, everything. Like, makes no sense. Okay. Huh, I see. So the obvious play is then just attacking him to the face, returning my 4-4. I guess. There's no other way to deal with this, right? No. So obviously, it's a 2-for-2, but I saved my stronger creature. He's down on life. I have a counter spell up. He's up a card, and he's down 2 mana. Okay, but I'll be playing from behind here. And I think he actually drafted a rush deck seeing which cards he has already played. Really? Not a bad draw, huh? More probably the best draw I could get there. You can still have easier ways to deal with this, like this into this. I would have a 5-1 divine shield and a 4-4. Both of them take care of it, combined with the hero power anyway. That's gonna get countered. So counterspell saves a creature, and this is why I don't like counterspell. Like, sure, if it's counter something like a Holy Nova or something like that, or game breaking spell, way better. But as it is now, it's not that great. Flesh eating ghoul, take that, grow it. I guess I'll run this out there. Yeah. It's a warlock, not a lot I can do about this. And actually next turn I can have 12 damage with this, because I can bounce it. Bounce, bounce, bounce. It's actually a pretty cool combo, by the way. Just giving plus, like this card is one of the best commons there is. 4 mana 4-4 and a great battle cry. Like pump effects are really strong at this point. And I actually think the previous metagame in Constructed Tandem, not the current metagame, I think the current metagame has changed a bit. But the previous one was all about pumping your own creatures, the 3 mana +1/+1, Dark Iron Dwarfs, Sword of Justice, stuff like that. It's okay, 5-7. Guess that's good. It's obviously good. Yeah, because it'll kill this. It'll force me to trade somehow, I guess. Nope. And I'm gonna bring that back, doesn't seem that smart, but I want to save it. Like, at 4-1 it's pretty weak. And even with this combination, I actually rather have a 3-2 in play than a 4-1, just because this is weak to Mortal Coil and these aren't. And we're up one card. He's down on low life against the mage, so he can't actually afford to life that easily. Or he at least has to consider it a bit more. Then just when he's at 3rd life, he can life tap whatever he wants. Okay. That's a pretty good card. Ah, oh, goddammit. Well, we can still take it all out, so. It's fine. Wow, that's even a better one. Yeah, drawing that, well, maybe, like the Dark Iron Dwarf is also good, but at least the Dark Iron Dwarf buff is permanent. And I'd rather have that on a creature that will stay in play. So we're only up a single card, and he's gonna life tap, huh? I think I then wanna go for the face. Okay, useless card. Useless card. So kill, kill, hit him, or dead. Spell damage. I was like, how on earth did I just did extra? But spell damage, of course. Because I was thinking 1-1, ping it, attacking for 8, ping it the next turn. But this is obviously better. Life tapping there puts him in a rougher spot, doesn't it? Like he now has to have double removal. That's not even gonna do anything, it's just a trash card. I'm just gonna Kodo it. And kill him with a super 2-1. Five to Not as pleased that I should be, but it's not a bad score with the deck I have, but I obviously want more wins. So let's keep going here. 9-2 would be the dream. And as usual, I'm not gonna stop the recording here until I take my third loss. I have done it in the past and I will keep on doing it for now. And actually, I'm being a bit selective in what I upload. Usually some decent drafts or really good ones. You probably noticed if you follow this in general. What I'm uploading, what I'm not. I'm gonna keep the 2-1, it's a great 1-drop against the Warrior. Great 1-drop, a great 2-drop, and a pretty bad 3-drop, a 5-drop. Like, it's not a bad 5-drop, but it's late. And I like that this is actually a 3-3 on its own. If it can't choose a minion, you can still play it as a 3-3. Like, in Magic the Gathering, this would just be... this would just be a 0-0. Or a 1-1, like something really terrible where you can only effectively use it for its ability. So he's gonna coin, hopefully a weapon. Well, hopefully not a weapon, because a weapon is really good, but... oh man, I hate that card. But it did coin for it. The question is, do I really want to run another creature in it? I don't think I do. Nope. I'm just gonna kill it. Real slow. I don't want to lose on card advantage. Like, I can't get tempered out here. Yeah, he doesn't have a 2-drop, so that's fine for me now. Because... he didn't get tempered out. And I think my next turn plays being either Water Elemental or these two. Depending on what he does. Okay, so it's gonna be a Water Elemental. And he still can't kill that. I think a 3-6 is pretty hard for a Warrior to deal with. He has a Weaponsmith or Yeti. Yeti, Yeti, Yeti. Really? Not what I would do. Because I can freeze this shit now. Can even kill it. Are we up a card? No, we're down half a card because of this. Yes. I mean, I can ping it, but... it's not gonna do anything at this point. And it's a Warrior, so he has stuff like Arcanite Reaper, Gorehall, most of the time. Wow, really? What does he have here then? That is his play. It's a really odd play to do there, to attack me. Like, I'm still at 26, he's obviously not being able to rush me. Yeah, okay. Why didn't he attack there then? The question is, will I ooze? I don't think I'll ooze here. Yep, okay. It's a 2-2 weapon, so it can't kill the 2-3. He can with cleave now, so we take the 2-3, then cleave. Or that was also a possibility. You can kill that with the code though. Well, okay. Interesting. Now we'll let the code take care of business. Don't just attack that. Ah, fuck, I forgot the ping. I'm an idiot. I missed the damage. But we're playing slow against the Warrior, who hasn't used his weapon yet. Okay, so he does have the cleave. And he had it previously, which is pretty odd. 4-6, okay. How to deal with a 4-6? I think the main problem is the enrage part about it. Can't imp monster. Cause then he attacks and kills this. I don't want to give him a target to attack onto. And I wanna kill it next turn anyway. Stormwind champion attack. Like if he ignores this I can still kill it thanks to his Stormwind champion. That's what I was on about. Oh, I see. Yeah, it doesn't make a difference. Still doesn't make a difference. Ready, sir. Yeah, what do you think that you could attack this? Why is this... Is this plus 2 attack? Okay. Really? No, you should ignore this and attack this with your weapon. He has no clue what he's planning, right? Okay. Interesting. Interesting. Kill this. Bounce this, play this, we'll kill one of these two. Play this. I'm still at 18. I don't assume the Guardian's hand is that strong. So I probably want to ooze here and hope it's not another weapon. If it is though, I'm screwed. Okay. I don't mind that. I do mind that a bit. We'll find out where his last card was. Oh my god, a really good one. Well, it's not game breaking. He has 11 damage here, brings me down to 7. So I have to have taunts. Really? It's not gonna turn out as good as he hoped. You can do both of those and kill everything. A really good draw. And then next turn, manipulator this, play this. Wow, this game seems over. So it does have a Gorehound, huh? Which is just top decked, of course. Like, there's no way my opponent never top decks. If he attacked me previously, that would have been game, by the way. In this case, it's not. But any haste guy will kill me. I don't think... No. Bellocry is on stack. So if I copy this, it doesn't kill the Gorehound. If he has a 4-3 charge here, I lose. Yeah, I would have lost. If he knew he had Gorehound, I would have attacked with all on me previous turn and brought me down to 7. It wouldn't have made a huge difference, but... It would have been a better play. So it does go for me, no? Interesting. Okay. The longer he attacks my creatures, the happier I am, of course. Because it means he doesn't have the kill here. I guess I'll use it, one of them. To generate a bunch more imps. Well, really? He has 5 damage here. Oh, he could have Mortal Strike. Okay. So that probably means he doesn't have it. It would have slammed it. Don't care about that. Don't care about that. Don't care about that. A friendly minion, right? Yeah. So it goes down to 11. Obviously you don't have enough, but the question is how do I want to deal with this? I probably don't want to polymorph it. I could copy it to gain some defense. Nah. Let's fuck that shit up. So the armor unit gained him to. The longer the goal house keeps on attacking, the better I feel about my own life total. Oh my god. Whirlwind, the card no one ever should play, because it's trash. Down to 8, down to 7. Yeah, goal house. Nuts card. Down to 6 spell damage. And now his Gorehall is basically a useless card anyway. Or becoming useless card. But it did keep him in this game. And I know I could have not pinged and played 2 4/4s. Which would then be lethal the next turn, but I just want to play safe. Like if he has like a dead wing or something, I can polymorph it. If he has something else huge, I can copy it and then polymorph it. I just don't want to be outdrawn here, and this is the better play not to. Because basically with these two cards, anything big I can handle. This is GG. Goal, so 6-2, keep on going. So longer video as usual, but I don't think anyone ever minds. I might be streaming tonight apparently. Just got asked if I wanted to. Another warrior. Decent hand, obviously not a sea giant, but Swampoos and Apprentice are. And the second Swampoos. Really good hand against warriors. Because fuck warriors. So we lead out with Sorcerer Apprentice, hope he drops a weapon, play Swampoos, hope he drops another weapon, play Swampoos. Something like that. But then he shouldn't coin out something big. It's not that great of a hand just because all your creatures are weak, but the Swampoozes are pretty strong against warriors. Faceless Manipulator, not so much. It's slow, and you probably want these cards in the late game when big creatures do matter. So it does go out something here, probably 2-3. It's a terrible Mad Bomber. which deals me 2 damage. And we get our sea giant, yay. So Mad Bomber, I'm not a fan of. Like, I never was, I think. I hate random number generator. I do like, it's a good design card. I'm not gonna argue about that. Please go for, it doesn't matter what it goes for. I think here I actually have to go with the ooze. That's a good one. Yeah, let's do this. I get a 2/3, it's not that strong here. But combined with my hero power, it's gonna trade with whatever anyway. And if he had a weapon, it would force it out. So I'm not putting him on a weapon, or at least not a fear war axe, so running out of single ooze is fine here. I want to keep up creatures in play. So now he does have a weapon, yay him. Logical, right? You run out of ooze and then they have a weapon. So just a 4/4. Eventually this will become a beast, and then we can copy it. Copy the beast. How good is this with stuff like Ink Monster? Okay, so he attacks that, we play this, kill that. Okay, it's fine. Kapoosh! So we are keeping control of the board. That's one thing. We are getting into the late game. We have an answer to whatever broken weapon he could have. As a warrior, he probably has some Arcanite Reaper, Gorhal. Gorhal is just, wow, so sick. You saw it last game, how hard it is if you can't deal with it. We obviously won, but it just generates so much card advantage. And if he attacked right the previous time, if he knew he had a Gorhal, I don't see why he wouldn't attack me. If he did that though, I think my play would have been different. Is he gonna take the trade up himself? Yeah, okay. And then what? Okay. I don't want to run out my Jungle Panther. Cleave is too strong and too likely that he has it, that I don't want to run out two creatures that both die to it and offer him a 2-for-1. Like, at one point in the game I'll have to play into Cleave, but today is not that day. Of course. We can ping that down though. We have to ping that down. We can get a 3/3 taunt along with it. Or we can get a 4/2, I guess. We're gonna take 7 then. Hmm. 3/3 taunt or a 4/2 that kills a 3/3 later on. What's my next turn play after that? I think. Yeah, this is better. If he has a weapon, he has to show it here, or he will show it here. If he doesn't, it just gets rid of a bunch of creatures. Obviously I can't run double sea giant now, but so he does have a weapon. He actually just drew his weapon. But at least now I'll get rid of it and I'll play a swamp ooze and a sea giant. We should be able to take over the game. Just show me, bro, what do you got? We're actually... he's still a card up. But I'm at a healthy life total into the end game against the warrior as a mage. I don't actually have the insane mage cards here though. Well, Blizzard is good against the warrior, I guess. But he didn't seem to be playing warrior record deck either. This is actually my 7th win, and 7 wins is key into going even or getting your money back, so this game is where it all depends on. Whee. The fact that he's deciding so hard probably means he doesn't have a lot of good things. So yeah, even if he has to trade, I'm fine with that. Two seven doesn't bother me even in the slightest. I'm gonna ping that. I don't think the one damage on him is gonna matter. And then next turn with the Stormwind champion and this, we can, or Stormwind champion attack, ping it. Or Stormwind champion into this also does things. Like, one extra damage on this isn't gonna make a difference for him, but it might make a huge difference for me. While one damage on him isn't gonna make a difference, because I think it's gonna all depend on interesting. So he's gonna trade there. It's basically still a 1-for-1. The question is, how do I want to deal with this? Yeah, I can kill all of his creatures. It's fine. And then next turn we can bring out even bigger baddies. Unless he gets rid of this right now. Yeah, faceless manipulators are really good. Okay. So a shitty whirlwind down. And a shitty card down. So we obviously copy this, right? Like, I don't see why it wouldn't. I don't think there's a lot of cards that will get him out of this. Obviously Gorlhal will, but that won't. I'll just trade with that. And then what? I'm left with a 6-6 even. Like that. I find that to be a weird mechanic. And with that I mean the fact that if you like, it was a 7-6, it was a 7-7 with one damage on it, and then the +1/+1 effect vanishes, and then it becomes a 6-6, so it basically only loses less than it should. I'm willing to use my Blizzard on this. And I don't think he has an out here. Not even Gorhal now. Yep, well played. Why couldn't I? Okay. So yeah, yes, 7 wins. Let's keep on going and hope we get 2 more. But I'll be pleased if I end up with 7, I think. I obviously want more, I'm greedy fuck. But getting less is no downside. 7 wins, you at least break even. And like, people say you break even, you break even. Yeah, you break even on gold, but you get a free pack, you get some dust, maybe. You just don't break even, you actually gain something. So we're up against a rogue. Whoa. does have some aggression. I'm actually gonna keep all of these. Like turn 1 coin, turn 2, turn 3, turn 4. And if I have to play slower and I play slower, these combinations are gonna be good. Yeah, I'm gonna run this out there. The Murloc is gonna be really good. He could have backstab. And if he just daggers up and attacks this, he's gonna take a bunch of damage. And Brewmaster combinations. He's gonna attack it, huh? No, he's gonna attack me, actually. No, attack it! Attack it! Yeah, do it! It's gonna be his worst play ever. He takes 3 to the face for nothing. Six damage, wasted turn. How cool wasn't that? So yeah, Brewmaster combinations, usually strong. 3-3 taunt on the other hand, pretty good. We obviously get a 4-3. He could have deadly poison here. Like that would make sense. Or that. Guess that also makes sense. The question is, how do you want to kill it? Do you want to run in creatures? Yeah, that's fine. The 4-2 stealth will usually trade up. It might not, depend on what it does or what it has. The 2-1 is gonna die. Like the only reason why it's out there is to pump my 2-3. It does seem to be a slow rogue deck, or it might be because he was on the play that he has to play it a bit slower. Good card. I can only play it myself. And that's also a good card. So how to do this? Attack, kill, but then we can't ping. We obviously want to ping that. Yeah, that's fine. Like now, one of these two plus a ping will trade with that. If he elects not to, he can charge it down. But at this point, his combo cards are gonna become more powerful. Any 3 toughness guy can also kill. Guess he's not willing to do though. He takes an extra damage. Yeah, go me. Interesting. That's fine because I'm gonna return it anyway. The question is. Okay, I see the play. Might not have been the correct play, but I think it is. I could have attacked, killed, pinged, and then it would be left with a 2-1, which I could ping the next turn anyway, but it would have ended in the same. Because the 2-1 would still trade with my 3-2. Like, the end result would still be what it is right now. So we're even on cards while I was on the draw. Okay. It's a good one. So he gains the board advantage. And here I take it back. Again, what's the reason behind the ping on this and not on him? I do not have any reach. If he wants to take the trade now, he has to take the trade instantly. He can't heal it up. And it will trade with this later on. Stuff like that. It's in Frostbolt range. I do not actually have Frostbolt, but okay. This now costs 2, right? Okay. So he probably wants to trade here anyway, but like, there's not a lot that I can keep on doing here. And if he trades like that, he's still left with a 5-2 to deal with. Yeah, okay. And he has to be scared about the secret. Like, he probably doesn't want to run out his best creature first, because he's scared that I'm gonna get a copy of it. Mages don't have anything that if you attack a creature it changes, so that's never gonna matter. And he actually knows the content of my hand as well. It's a really good card, by the way. So yeah, here he is just testing out what secret it is. So I'm gonna kill those. Ping attack. So he attacks that. Enrages it, attack this. I have to play this. Yeah, I have to. So he attacks my 1/4. He keeps a weapon and attacks my 4/2. Yeah, playing the Imp Master might not have been the smartest, but once I decided on doing that, I had to go through with the rest of it as well. Like, I can get rid of the 4/5 now, but he's up 2 cards on me. Unless he plays something really good. Oh, goddammit. That's really good. And I have to get rid of that as well. Again, as much damage on the creatures right now as I can. But this getting stealth, if he elects never to attack with it, it's gonna be really good weapons for 2 mana. Oh, he does get rid of it, really. Okay, that explains. So what do I want faces manipulator? Actually don't think I wanted that, but okay. Yeah, just get keep on pinging that. So now he has a 4/5 to deal with. And he's smart enough to go for me. Like, it's gonna be GG anyway. With the weapons. Yeah. There's no way I can win this. Interesting. So yeah, this is why I don't like secrets, they do nothing. Well played. I'm gonna ping myself. Blizzards. Doesn't save me. Dude, end your turn already. Thank you. Meh, 7-3, not that disappointed. It's a decent result for the deck. And I still feel like you should be able to watch your deck right here, right now. Or at least have a history of the decks you drafted and played with. Seems to be a bit more entertaining, like you probably want that. So yeah, we actually gained 35 gold in the pack. So it's not even break even, it's 135 gold. Because the pack is 100 gold, people don't seem to realize that. That if you count the pack, you usually Really? They're trash though. Man, it's a really good pack. Like a rare double epic and really good cards. Like Murchok, maybe not. Not in the current meta. But it's not that bad. Anyway, thanks for watching. I'll see you for next one.